the final push on the eve of an historic election in America. President Trump and Joe Biden racing across battleground states, their closing arguments in the final hours of their campaigns. The president holding 5 rallies in 4 key states today, telling voters in Pennsylvania if he wins there, he wins, quote, the whole thing. The president making news on the eve of the election, strongly hinting at a rally that he could fire Dr. Fauci after Election Day, the crowd cheering. Tonight, Joe Biden traveling to Ohio and Pennsylvania. He plans to visit Scranton, too, where he lived as a boy, saying it's time for Donald Trump to pack his bags and go home, arguing we must unite the country and we must get the virus under control. Tonight, the historic early vote in this pandemic, more than 97 million ballots already cast. The path to 270 electoral votes, and tonight there's a reason Joe Biden and President Trump are visiting Pennsylvania. Why that state is so crucial this time, also tonight we'll take you through the scenarios. What happens if President Trump wins Florida? What's his path from there? And what happens if Joe Biden wins Florida? What we could know early, and what could spell a very long election night, a very long election week ahead. The backdrop of this election, the coronavirus here in the U.S. Tonight, cases surging in 47 states, including battlegrounds. The president will land in Wisconsin tonight, where just today they hit a 7-day high in cases. The president repeatedly saying we're rounding the corner. But tonight, Dr. Fauci's blunt warning, quote, we're in for a whole lot of hurt. The possible terror attack overseas, images coming in at this hour, gunmen armed with rifles opening fire at 6 locations. And back here at home tonight, the volunteers across America guiding voters at the polls in this pandemic, in this historic election. They are America strong.
From ABC News World Headquarters in New York, this is World News Tonight with David Muir.
Good evening, and it's great to start another week with all of you at home. And what a year this has been, a once-in-a-century pandemic, so many American families affected. And tonight we find ourselves on the eve of a historic election. And early, you can see President Trump with 306 electoral votes, way past the 270 needed to win. So one of the big headlines besides his victory was, as you mentioned, that blue wall collapse. We're talking about these Rust Belt states, Wisconsin, Michigan, and Pennsylvania. Those he would become. But red, that he will get reelected. But this is where
flip Pennsylvania to red, because the president has spent a lot of time there. What does that do?
All right, David. So look right now at President Trump's number, 280. If he keeps all the same states he had 4 years ago and he can defend Pennsylvania, he can keep it red, that he will get reelected. But this is where things sort of get interesting, and this is how things are different. This year, North Carolina and Georgia and